Go on then.
Oh yeah. Hello, YouTube. So, here I am. Beautiful morning, about -2. Just doing my usual morning routine. I either go train or I go for a run. Today I thought I'd go for a run, because weather's nice. Well, nice-ish, fucking freezing again. Doggy is, you'll remember, Maddie from previous vlogs. She was fitter and healthier back then. Now she's flagging. She's flagging. Back there, I was running. She was about 20 yards behind me. I was like, come on, bitch. She's like, God. She's like, I'm fucked. Mad. Right. Gets a bit of a limp on her as well. Oh, God, I'm not good with the camera as well. Gets a bit of a limp on her as well. Poor dog. Whew. Well, I'm going to run back because I feel bad for her. You're limping, aren't you? Yeah, poor dog. Morning routine, I'll see you all at home. Come on.
Feels.
Oh. I came to a sad realisation today. I do it often. Well, I've known it for a while, actually. The dog, it's getting older. And, do you know what? If you'll notice, if you've got a pet or a dog, when you first take it out, they're a puppy, like, lively, and they're, like, running about for ages, and you can never stop them. And then, sometimes you might spend a little bit of time away from them, maybe you personal life work shit gets in the way, like as for me, and then you get a bit of free time, you try and spend some time with the dog, and you realise how much older they've got, and then the end is nigh. She's not dead yet, but she, you know, she's kicking on, aren't you, Mad? You're 12 soon, you know, that was light work what we just did, and you couldn't even, you know, you were flagging, darling, but it's okay. I mean, you used to blitz shit like that, didn't you? But it's alright, anyway, because you're getting old. But yeah, sad realisation that doggo is getting older and older. Still love a kiss though, don't you? Knows all the tricks in the book, this one. Look at the camera. Alright, whatever's in. On to today's YouTube video! Today's video is Workout Wednesday. We're going to be working out on golf specific. I'm giving you the power program today and I'm going to show you through all of it. Reps, sets, volumes, tempos, the lot. The full program for one of the days. Obviously, I'm not going to do all 3 days in one. So, Workout Wednesday. We're going to have to get at it. At the current moment, I'm working away very, very hard. It's also about what you need to do to become the best in this industry. Now, I'm by no means the best. I'm not going to state that. But I know what it takes to become the best because I'm currently trying to do it. You've got to constantly move. One of the main things about trying to becoming the best in the industry is moving with the tide, almost. So with this industry, you get a lot of different views, you get a lot of new study. It's very scientific for obvious reasons. It's the body. There's always new research coming out, and it's what's reliable and what's not. But when a reliable study comes out and you read it and you think, shit, that's just gone against everything that I have previously believed in, you've got to be able to move with the tide. You've got to be able to change your way of thinking to how and respond positively to how that research has impacted results future results, future views and things like that. So a good example of it is lately, so I'm a big believer in you know, you can't burn fat and build muscle at the same time. I thought it was impossible, which studies in the past have shown, but recent studies have come out, reliable studies, evidence-based, have come out to say that you can, only within a very, 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 very specific sort of, you know, state. You know, you've got to be spot on with your nutrition, and the results are minuscule and things like that, but people think that it's the next big thing. You've got to be able to move with that tide and understand that that's how, you know, that does happen in this industry. So that's one of the things it does take to become the best. You've got to be quite diverse, you could be open-minded, try not to be fixed, or you'll get lost, you'll get left behind, and you'll become, you know, a dinosaur. So that's one of the things, and there's others as well. You've got to be very, very emotionally intelligent. You've got to be able to, you know, adapt to all different types of client. If you're just a general PT, you're going to be dealing with general client bases, but every person's different, and they've all got different personalities, and they all react to you differently. For example, I have one client, Rob. He's very quiet, but he's very, very driven, very focused. Where you've got to constantly reassure him that he's on the right track, but you've got to speak to him. You can't be like bold or anything like that. You could be quite mellow and chilled and calm in your delivery, but he's very focused, so you've got to be spot on. And then you've got other clients who are just like my old client Adam, who was just off his tits all the time. Not on, like, but like he was, you know, very energetic emotionally. So you've got to be quite the same, so you can adapt to their personality, and then you retain the client better. It's the same with politics, it's the same in business and friendships, and, you know, well, if you want to be friends with people who are quite different, then yeah. So that's another one of the things. Speaking in front of the camera could be good. You've got to connect with your personality, you've got to connect with your audience. This is why I'm doing YouTube, is to connect more with you, to get something out of you, to tell me what to do, or to move forward, where to go, what you want from me. I produce content daily, like ridiculous amounts, probably more than any PT who works in the gym that I work at. However, some other people have got better businesses than I do, and it's all about developing to you. So those are a couple of things that it takes to become the best in the industry. Like I say, I'm not the best, but I'm trying to become. And then today, yeah, workout Wednesday. So I'm going to show you through a workout. Let's head to the gym. Right, just before I go to training, I've put together my pre-training drink. Now, it's something I haven't had for ages. I'm just doing it for YouTube, obviously. Right, so we've got Ribena flavour, maltodextrin, which is like an intra-carb, and creatine, which is good for strength. Bang them all together, a bit of water on the way to training, have it intra as well. Well, it's intra-training drink really, it's not actually my pre. Pre is coffee, because it's caffeine for me. Right, so we are at the gym, and today's session is the first one on the power program, or the distance program. First up is deadlifts. Well, actually, no, it's not. I lie. It's first up is mobilization. So I'm going to mobilize for a bit, show you the one. Are you drunk enough now to judge what I'm doing? Are you high enough to excuse that I'm ruined? Cause I'm ruined. Is it late enough for you to come and stay over? Cause we're free to love. Stop teasing me. I made no promises. I can't do golden rings, but I'll give you everything. Right, we are warmed up, and first exercise up is deadlift. Now, my back's a bit injured, so here's a video of me doing a deadlift. Second up, we've got dumbbell row. So my dumbbell row, I'm all right, because I haven't got much stabilisation in my back, so I'm okay. So, single arm dumbbell rows, here we go. But I'll give you everything. Magic is in the air. There ain't no silence here. So come get your everything. Time, 8 reps, moving that weight up, strength. Hit 2 posterior movements on a big power program, mainly for posture in the golf swing. And next up will be this rotational. It's final one, final set, last set, best set. So, from posterior to core, first core movement, disc sliding plank, fucking killed there. The first one I did was fine, when I'm resting on my left arm. But when I rest on my right, it looks like I've got wires in my elbow, so it's hard to rest. That's about like a mat, but the disc doesn't slide on the mat, so it's fucking solid. So to improvise a little bit, so you push away, push towards the forearm, push further away. Next one up is a twisting movement, but it's for the hips. It's engaging the hips. What you saw there was it's a hip mobilizer, so it's getting used to that quite a rotation of the hip during take away the golf swing up to the top and then through impact. So it's not quite through the full force of the follow through yet, but it's learning to twist that hip through impact. Next up, we've got kneeling cable twist. Thank you.
Alright, so that was kneeling cable twist. That was our twist in motion for our core. And it was on the cable machine. We usually could do it with the resistance band as well. Resistance band's pretty hard, took tension all the way. But next up is bar twists for mobility, and it's our last move. As you can see from that last movement there, what that's practicing is getting mobility through the golf swing. So, through the takeaway all the way to the top of the golf swing. If we can get our hands higher and further back, then you increase the chances of releasing more power. So if you release more power, then you create more clubbing speed, create more clubbing speed, create more distance. That's why it's called the distance program. So here, two big posterior movements. Posterior chain is meant for developing, excreting power and extension of the body. The core movement for that, if we can create a really strong core, then we can maintain our height and our balance of the golf swing. We've hit our core twisting movement underweight, which is also strengthening the twist of the body. Then we've hit this more mobilization movement there as well, where we can actually gain a higher reach at the top of the golf swing. And then even extend it through the follow through, so you're synchronizing it into your golf swing. So that's been this session today, and as you can see, I'm sweating like hell. It is harder than it looks. Give it a try, give me a message if you want to get in with the coaching. The Swing Fit program is launched now, so you will get it. See you later. You ain't think tonight.